Who Am I? The Punk Rock Attitude. Today we're going to be discussing the Attitude's music in the Milwaukee scene and how they all relate to punk rock. Joining us, we have Nick Stathis, who is the owner of Nico's, one of the few punk or new wave nightclubs in Milwaukee. And also joining us are the members of the band D. Kreuzen, who will be performing for us in a little while. Welcome, all of you.
Thank you.
Dan, where are you from? What's your part in the group?
I'm from Rockford, Illinois, and I'm a singer.
Okay, Keith.
I'm from Brookfield, Wisconsin, and I play bass.
And Eric?
I'm from Brookfield with Keith, and I play the drums.
And Herman?
And I'm also from Rockford and play guitar.
Nick, what's the difference between punk rock and new wave?
Well, punk rock is more hardcore or hard sounding. It has lyrics that are very hard to the ear. The music is hard. New wave is a little more easier and sort of dancey. Also, hardcore is a slam bang dance type thing. It looks like a football field with guys tackling and scrimmaging on the dance floor. The language is a little hard also.
So when your bar is referred to as hardcore punk, that's the kind of stuff we can expect?
You sure can.
Okay.
Good time.
Do you have more problems with your patrons there than you would have, say, at another rock club or a country bar or something?
No, I don't think so. I found the people are very pleasant and very interesting, although some of them are strange. I one time referred it's Halloween by me all the time. But I found that the group is a very good group of people. A lot of them come from very fine homes from Brookfield, Waukesha, and the surrounding suburbs.
Is it commercially successful?
It can be.
You get a large crowd in there?
Oh, yes, depending on what we're booking and who we're booking at the time.
Who are the most popular people besides D. Kreuzen?
Well, D. Kreuzen and Sacred Order and the Amidots and Tense Experts and the Dummy Club. The Dummy Club's basically more new or hip rockabilly. Who else we have?
INRI, GFO,
right.
Really good.
Okay.
Bands.
Here's an obvious question. What does D. Kreuzen mean?
Well, we swiped it out of a German language Bible that we found.
The Bible, what does it mean?
It means the sign of the cross.
Punk rock has a reputation for being really violent. Are you into that? Are you violent?
No, I'm not.
I think that's
just
basically like what the media lets the people see. You know, they go at it, you know, they hear about all the violence, and so they direct
A few little things happen, you know, a few incidents, and then the media takes that and they'll just blow it all out of proportion. Yeah. You know, a bottle will fall on the floor and somebody will slip and cut their hand or something, and they'll say somebody went
right away, somebody slashed their neck or something,
and then slashed and
blood all over the floor.
So you don't think the reputation is deserved?
No. I think it's gotten a lot better.
What it boils down to is people are going to be, you know, if people are going to be violent, they're going to be violent anyway, and it's not necessarily associated with the music at all, really.
Okay, I've heard some of your music and it, while it may not be exactly violent, it is kind of rambunctious. Where is all that energy coming from?
Inside.
Just from inside, you know.
What inspires your music?
Everything.
Everything, just, you know.
Work.
Just working, just the way just things happen to
living.
Us.
Yeah. Yeah.
Living
things that happen every day.
You live downtown. Do you think you get a better vantage point living downtown?
There's a lot more things to do there. It's not so boring as living in the suburbs or something.
A lot more people to see.
Yeah.
You know, just walk down Grand Avenue one day and it's like...
You said that you, I should ask you, what bores you? What do you think is boring?
The list from here till next Tuesday.
Yeah. Radio, television, most of the things that were fed in the media.
Do you think TV's boring?
I never watch it.
A lot of it. A lot of it is
like
real.
Except when I come home from work, I watch Green Acres.
And that's just it. That, you know, it's like, it. Granted, it's supposed to be escapism, but a lot of it is just like mindless, rather than, you know, even not educational, but just, you know, something to run through your head and you don't even have to think about it. That's really bad.
Like Three's Company? Something like that. Yeah. So, sit and watch that and, oh, that's the way things really are.
Five minutes later, you've forgotten it completely. You know, it's like,
So this music really sort of expresses your frustration with that boredom?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a way of, playing music is a way of getting away from the boredom and having something to do.
And plus it gives the people.
Yeah, for us and for the people that listen to it.
Yeah. Movement came out of the slums of England, but that doesn't exactly coincide with Rockford, Illinois. Do you have any kind of relationship with that movement?
Not really.
No, it's really a totally different thing.
Yeah.
So you don't consider yourselves political?
No.
It's a personal basis, maybe, yeah. but not
Washington
with
politics
the government and all that. Yeah.
We try and stay away from that.
Why did you decide to call your album Cows and Beer?
That's the stereotype of Milwaukee. What's in Milwaukee?
Farmers.
Beer.
Farmers. Cows.
Or making fun of people who stereotype us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if they want to stereotype us, well.
Yeah,
here's the record.
Yeah, here's the record.
People who have that image before they even see us or any of the other bands from around here and say, well, there can't be anything in the Midwest at all. You know, it's all out on the coasts. Well, that's a total falsehood.
Okay. You're based here in Milwaukee, then. Yeah. Do you play in other cities and states?
No, we played, like,
Indiana.
We just played Madison the other day.
Yeah.
Minneapolis,
Chicago, Indiana.
We're going on tour starting June.
First week in June.
Mm-hmm. That's going to be down south in Texas,
Arizona,
across to California.
California, Nevada.
Up and over back in
Oklahoma.
And hopefully we won't kill ourselves.
Yeah, if we make any money,
roast in the desert.
What kind of relationships do you have with your parents? Do your parents appreciate what you're doing?
We practice in my mom's basement.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
good. They love mine, appreciate it, but you know they're not saying, "Oh, you shouldn't be doing that. It's just terrible." You know, they help me out.
They encourage you.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Freedom
because,
of choice.
Because they know it's something that I want to do.
Yeah, they know it's
it's
what I want to do. So
what I've wanted to do for a long time. So.
And we're making it happen for ourselves.
Great.
Yeah.
How did the group get together?
Just
me and Brian, or Herman, moved from Rockford up here with one other person, and he lost interest in the band, so we picked up Keith, and then we found Eric, and it just kind of came about.
Nick, you were mentioning you have some problems with that. These bands seem to come and go, they break up pretty frequently.
Well, they have little scrimmages between each other once in a while, and before you know it, all of a sudden I'll get a phone call, we can't play tonight because one of our members dropped out, and this month is kind of rough in that perspective. I've had two groups coming up from Indiana, and the last minute they call up and cancel. So that puts a bind on the situation when we're trying to bring in music, especially when we have it already booked and advertised, and people are expecting this particular group to be there. And it's kind of hard.
Okay. How long have the four of you been together as a group?
It's coming close to
almost 2 years now.
It'll be 2 years on... pretty close to Halloween.
No,
is
May.
It June?
May.
No.
Yeah.
Somewhere's around there.
And you have a few more albums. Can you give me the names?
Well, we're on a compilation album called The Master Tape.
Yeah,
that's your most recent one?
And that was the first one, and then we put our EP out. That's called
Cows and Beer. And after the tour, we're going to try and get it back in the studio for a 12-inch EP.
Which do you prefer? Do you prefer recording, or would you rather play to a live audience?
Oh, play
in
live
audience is
infinitely preferable.
The, the audience gets into your music and gives
it's
you
a
the
lot.
Energy.
Yeah, plus it's like it gives us energy to watch people out there enjoying
plus
it.
Plus, if they're going at it gives us something to feed off and give them more of what we've got to offer.
It's like really difficult to play if everybody's just sitting there, you know, drinking their martinis or whatever. Sure. You know.
Is it all original music?
Yeah, we write all our own stuff.
Do you collaborate, or how do you go about, does someone have an idea for a song and then somebody else contributes?
Right.
Yeah.
If someone just happens to come up with an idea, we'll sit and work with it. If it has
if we all like it, we'll try and write another part.
Build onto it.
A lot of times it takes a while.
Yeah.
We kind of shuffle parts around and put a part in here and there, and if we don't like it, we throw it away. Yeah. And gradually a song comes out.
We throw away far more than we use.
Yeah,
to.
Yeah.
How do you decide what finally goes on the album?
Whatever makes us...
Yeah, whatever works the best.
Yeah.
You know, whatever sounds the best, whatever works the best when we play it, usually.
So what's in the future for you besides this tour down south? Do you have more albums planned?
Yeah, more recordings.
More records and
trying to set up a local label.
A local recording record company.
Yeah, helping out other bands.
Yeah, trying to get
around the Midwest.
Trying to get bands up here to play and just generally helping everybody out, you know, because if we're in a position, because a lot of people have helped us, and now that we're in a position to help people, we should do it.
Who are your inspirations? Who are your favorite musicians that you kept as ideals as you were working?
A lot of
yeah,
people.
It's really hard to say.
Yeah. Can really be narrowed down to.
Throw out some names. Who?
Well, the drummer for, used to be with DOA, Chuck Biscuits. Imagine you've heard of him, but he's really, really good. And I've really been inspired by him.
There's not so much anyone that I like so much that I would like be able to name like one person. It's just like the general attitude of a lot of people kind of like rubs off on you. Mm-hmm. You know, because it's like I'm self-taught. I haven't really like, we've never played anybody else's songs, so we're not like.
Yeah, we have. Well, done a few.
Well,
we've got a couple that we pull out once in a while.
But when we do it, we try and do
we try and play all our own stuff.
Yeah, but not to the extent where we would be like copying it or anything.
No.
Well, what's the Milwaukee music scene like now? Are you doing well? Are you getting well?
It's getting a lot better since like last year.
The hardcore scene has gotten a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
in the last a year and a half ago, I think that there was maybe like one. Band. And then in the last three months,
it's
totally exploded.
Three bands have popped out, which is INRI, GFO, and Disdain. And Sacred Order just recently broke up, but they're trying to reform,
that'll reform two more bands.
So
it's like a lot better than. There's a lot of different bands in Milwaukee, but there aren't that many bands that are doing a lot of different things. You know, they tend to
jump on someone else's bandwagon instead of trying to create their own fun.
Why do you think it's gotten better recently?
More input from the people.
People are listening.
They care
more
about
now.
It. And
they're listening and thinking more for themselves now, rather than just tending to blindly follow someone else.
Where is Nikos?
Nikos is located at 2nd and National on the corner. Look for the skull. Which it seems to be a symbolic symbol that represents the punk or hardcore movement.
And Nick Stathis is running for mayor?
I'm thinking about it. It's a serious thought right now. I feel that Mr. Meyer has no challengers, so I thought maybe I'd try it.
Huh. Well, I'd like to thank all of you for coming. Mm-hmm. And right now, the band, D. Kreuzen, will be performing for us. And while they set up, I'll run you down on what's happening here tonight for student operations. At 5:30, directly following this show, we have CPR, the ABCs of Life. At 6 p.m., we have the Hansberry Sands Theater Company. And at 8, we have Milwaukee's Answer to Comedy, or at least that's what the Actors Asylum tells us. Out of Sync, which features the Actors Asylum and the Chrismatics. At 9:30, we'll have Massage, the Technique of. At 11:30, we have Far Darig performing some Irish folk music. At 12 midnight, we have DG&G Patterns. This is a really unusual musical group, and they play their instruments in an unusual fashion. That will conclude Student Productions 1983. In the meantime, sit back, enjoy, keep an open mind. I'm intrigued to introduce you to the music of D. Kreuzen.
Walk! what changed me. You and I shouldn't fight, cause we know what's wrong and what's right. You and I should be friends. Together we can find the good in the end. You fight for what's right, fight for what's right. You fight for what's right, fight for what's right. You fight for what's right, fight for what's right.
the stick while you should get on the way home. You're so bad. You're made walk out your way out of bed and play. No sense in time. What do you know what makes me nice when you think I'm so happy? Your mother's gone to make a fresh father stick while you should get on the way home. You're so bad. You're made walk out your way out of bed and play. Die. The rest of you know what makes me top nice when lives to go so happily.
Kreuzen.